One of the main reasons why many fans are awaiting the second season of the newest Netflix hit, Squid Game, is because there's a huge chance that the police officer, Wang Jun Ho, might reappear in the succeeding season. After all, he's no doubt one of Squid Game's most compelling side characters. But before we get any deeper, just a reminder, spoiler alert, the new Netflix series is still a hit in many countries, and if you are one of the many souls who haven't finished watching the series yet, then get ready for a ton of spoilers, because I'm telling you, Squid Game's storyline is no game, and you will be mind blown with a lot of twists and unexpected turns. Now, let's talk about Jun Ho, the police officer, one of the many characters in the Squid Game series that captured our hearts. But before any of that, please first make sure that you hit that subscribe button and smash that notification bell for more updates on this. Now, let the games begin. Police Officer Jun Ho is a detective who made his way to Squid Game by infiltrating the ship that left the port and by disguising as one of the men in red overalls and creepy black mask. But he made his way to the viewers' hearts by showing what it's like on the other side of the Squid Game. He gave the series a whole new point of view that diverted our attention from the games and the players themselves. Unfortunately, he was shown in Episode 8 getting shot by the front man, who turns out to be his lost brother, In Ho, and the sole reason why he infiltrated the games to begin with. You may remember that Jun Ho was there at the police station when the main character and the winner of the game, Gi Hun, also known as Player 456, reported to the police station about the whole disturbing game of death and money. When Gi Hun realized there was no hope for him in the police station, he accidentally left the calling card the Squid Game recruiter gave him, which bore the three shapes that embodied the whole game: a circle, a triangle, and a square. Detective Jun Ho saw this, and it was marked on his mind since then. But the thought of the card bothered him most when he tried to visit his brother, who'd been missing for a while. He entered his flat, but he was nowhere to be found. When he saw a calling card with the same set of shapes as the one Gi Hun handed over to the police, that was when the whole adventure of Jun Ho started. From searching for Gi Hun for help, following him back to the game, and infiltrating the island by disguising as one of the men in red overalls. At that moment, almost everybody thought that Jun Ho's brother might have been killed off in the beginning of the game, in the first episode where the game Red Light Green Light had taken place. After all, almost half of the players lost in that game, so it wasn't impossible that Jun Ho's brother was one of the victims from the very first game. But no, the search for Jun Ho's brother became more interesting as he navigated us viewers inside the world of Squid Game. Through his eyes, we got an in-depth look at the day-to-day operations of the game and saw the perspective of those behind the games, from the masked men in red overalls to the office of the game master to the VIPs. This includes how workers live and work on the island and the frontman's files on Squid Game's current and previous players, which is how he finds out that his brother In Ho was one of the game's winners. Disguised as a server, Jun Ho also experiences firsthand how depraved the VIPs betting on the games can be. So there's no doubt here that the character of Jun Ho is a very important one, and he is no normal player. He is the key for the whole game to stop, and he might still be left alive for season 2 to help Gi Hun put a halt on the game for good. I know what you're thinking, but he was shot, right? Could he still be alive? Let's take a look at some of the evidence and fan theories. If you do think about it, there is indeed a huge chance that Jun Ho might still be alive, given the not-so-fatal wound he received from the Game Master's shot. It's obvious that the police officer had been shot just on his shoulder and nowhere fatal, then fell off from the cliff. But we all know that if you fall off a cliff and submerge in the water, there's a pretty high chance that you'll survive, especially for a trained police officer like Jun Ho, who had come too far only to be stopped by his own brother. Even before the encounter between Jun Ho and the frontman, who reveals himself as his brother, it had already been foreshadowed that the frontman might have been his brother. Throughout most of the series, the frontman remains behind the ominous mask, which is congruent with the strict rules of the anonymity for all Squid Game workers and staff. But in Squid Game Episode 8, the second to last episode of the survival drama, he finally takes off his iconic mask to reveal his face. In episode 7, Jun Ho had just confronted a Squid Game worker who was part of the organ harvesting operation on the island. After Jun Ho escapes, he inadvertently leaves behind his police ID. And when the frontman investigates the body of Jun Ho's victim, one of the Squid Game workers retrieves the ID and shows it to their leader. Rather than simply looking at the police ID and pocketing the evidence, the frontman stares at it for far too long, suggesting that he knows the cop. The frontman's orders to his henchmen regarding the intruder is to capture him alive. Apart from when he stopped the riot in the dorm room at the old man's command, this is the only other time in which the Squid Game leader shows mercy. Which is important to note. Why would he show mercy to someone who means nothing to him? However, as Jun Ho is a threat to the secrecy of Squid Game, In Ho shoots his brother in the shoulder, and the police officer is shown falling into the ocean below. However, Ho's body is never shown, one heavy hint that he might still be alive, clinging to his life somewhere. There's also no scene where In Ho and his workers go down from the cliff where Jun Ho was shot to find his body and finish the job. Apparently, In Ho doesn't want to finish the job and may have just given his brother a head start to run before it's too late. After all, for someone who's trained to shoot anyone without mercy, his attempt to hurt Jun Ho was an obviously more careful approach. As Jun Ho is both a resilient and resourceful police officer, it's highly likely that he somehow escaped the island and is alive and recovering from his non-fatal wound. Even if he couldn't get to the scuba gear in the island's caves, he could have left on a boat while In Ho and his workers became busy tending to the games and the VIPs. On the other hand, the Squid Game ending makes it clear the games are up and running. This suggests the whole set of evidence Jun Ho gathered may never have made it to the police. However, considering how rich and powerful the many nameless VIPs that bet on Squid Game were shown to be, it's just as likely that Jun Ho is still alive and that his hard-earned evidence was swept under the proverbial rug. Jun Ho could still very well be hiding and already plotting his next move to bring down Squid Game. If Netflix decides to push through with season 2, it would be a mistake not to bring back Jun Ho, who is easily one of the most compelling characters in the cast of Squid Game. Moreover, as the last season in Squid Game shows protagonist Song Gi Hun, played by Lee Jong Jae, is determined to move against the games as well. Jun Ho could have a very new rich ally on his side if his story continues in Squid Game season 2. Well, that's all for today. We hope you enjoyed that video, and if you did, make sure to watch our video on the shocking theory on why Ali is still alive in Squid Game. Also, don't forget to hit that like and subscribe button and smash that notification bell for more videos like this.